चलिए तो व्हाट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड जस्ट नाउ दैट एफ इज अ फंक्शन डोमेन टू रेंज इनवर्स, रेंज टू डोमेन इनवर्स के एग्जिस्टेंस के लिए कंडीशन क्या थी? बाइजेक्टिवनेस, बाइजेक्टिव होना चाहिए. बाइजेक्टिव इंप्लाइज वन वन एज वेल एज ऑन टू. एंड नाउ बिकॉज ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक फंक्शंस आर नॉट वन वन, ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक फंक्शंस आर नॉट वन वन, दस देयर इनवर्स डज नॉट एग्जिस्ट इन जनरल. तो इन जनरल में इनवर्स एग्जिस्ट करता नहीं है. अब सो हाउ डू वी टैकल विद दैट? व्हाट वी विल डू, वी विल रेस्ट्रिक्ट द फंक्शन. हाउ वी विल रेस्ट्रिक्ट द फंक्शन? वी विल एक्चुअली चेंज द डोमेन. किस तरीके से? वी विल फाइंड सच अ डोमेन वेयर द फंक्शन विल एक्चुअली बी बाइजेक्टिव. सपोज दिस इज जीरो, पाई बाय टू, पाई, थ्री पाई बाय टू, एंड देन अगेन टू पाई. सो बिफोर साइन फंक्शन वॉज यूज टू डिफाइन फ्रॉम जीरो टू टू पाई, बट बिटवीन जीरो टू टू पाई द वैल्यूज दे वर गेटिंग ओवरलैप. हाउ दे वर गेटिंग ओवरलैप? फॉर साइन वॉज एक्चुअली रिक्रिएटिंग द वैल्यूज, लाइक साइन इज जीरो एट जीरो एंड देन साइन इज जीरो एट पाई एज वेल. सो साइन पाई इज जीरो, साइन जीरो जीरो. सो यहां से साइन जीरो इक्वल्स टू जीरो एंड साइन पाई इज ऑल्सो इक्वल्स टू जीरो. इफ साइन इज जीरो एट टू एंगल्स द साइज नॉट साइन इज नॉट द साइन फंक्शन इज नॉट वन वन फॉर दिस. एंड नाउ इफ साइन इज नॉट वन वन हाउ कैन आई फाइंड द साइन इनवर्स? क्लियर? सो what did we do? We restrict the domain. Restrict the domain means cut the domain and get a smaller domain. We will find out some small domain. Ek choti domain find out kar lenge. A smaller domain that can help me. So I guess everybody know what that restriction could be. 0 to 2 pi, I have just shown you that it was not injective. So I have to cut 0 to 2 pi in a smaller fraction where the function could be injective. So if we consider instead of this, see, this is 0 and the whole rotation going from here to here. This is 2 pi. I don't want to consider this. Why? Because my function, sine function, is not 1, 1 in this. Instead of this, I consider pi by 2 minus pi by 2, this part. Clear? So if I consider this part, what is the benefit of this part? See, positive values covered by sine function from 0 to 2 pi means 0 to 1. This is covered. And here 0 to minus 1 negative value is covered, and 0 also is not coming twice because in this region first quadrant and fourth quadrant 0 is coming at only at one place, that is 0 itself. So if this is the kind of thinking I'm trying to generate, that if you are having your sign from minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 and close the bracket, of course. Why? Because minus pi by 2 helps you cover negative 1 and pi by 2 helps you cover positive 1. So if I choose this as my domain for sine function, sine theta I can take, I will be covering the whole region from minus 1 to 1. That means if my sign goes from minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, it covers all the values that sine theta could have given from 0 to 2 pi, both positive as well as negative. Clear? Now this function sine theta from this domain to this range is bijective, means 1 1, and on both the conditions are satisfied. Now both the conditions are satisfied, that means for each and every single value, each and every single theta, there will be only one value. Suppose x from minus 1 to 1, and for each x between minus 1 to 1, we can find some unique theta, so that sine theta will be equals to x. So what I am trying to say, that sine theta from minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 gives you minus 1 to 1 is a bijective function. That means it's 1 1, means har ek theta ke liye minus 1 se 1 ke beech mein ek unique value milegi, and har ek minus 1 se 1 ke beech mein you will be able to find some theta, inverse image or pre image you can call it, you'll be able to find. And now because I have just decided ki ha sine function now is a bijective function, that means I can find the inverse. Since sine theta from pi by 2, minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 goes from minus 1 to 1 is bijective, implies inverse function exists. Clear? So how would that inverse function be? That function will be sine inverse x, you can take from minus 1 to 1, which will take you to minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. This is what I am saying. I guess this thing is clear to everybody, that what was the actual problem. So this thing here, the inverse sine function denoted by this this thing here, which was actually the domain for sine function and now the range for the inverse function, is called the principal branch. This is defined as principal branch or principal values. Actually, sometime in some book, some author, they refer inverse function as arc sine. Clear? So you don't need to worry if somebody says arc sine y, that means sine inverse y, nothing difference is there. This is directly equals to sine inverse y they are trying to ask you. Okay. Now if we have this, then what I can say, anybody wants to take the screenshot can take. I'll move on next. Okay. Next I have, suppose before, what did I know before? Right, from my previous knowledge, I know that sine x is bounded between 1 to minus 1. Means at the most, sine function can attain the value 1, and at the minimum, sine function can attain the value negative of 1, where my sine x, where x is supposed to be lying between pi by 2 to negative pi by 2. That means, agar mera ye x, yahan pe, you can take it theta as well. If you want to change the notation, you can take it theta. If sine theta is between 1 to minus 1, then theta is between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. This satisfies कि अगर theta यहाँ पे है या x इस range में है, sin x की value इसी range में आएगी. For inverse function, I am just writing some points that you need to remember. They will be used in some properties or something else you can do. Now, if I have the inverse function, I'll sign it as 1. Now, the inverse function lies between, this will definitely lies will be between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. For all, now where did this y lie? This y will be in between 1 to minus 1. Means, how does the sine inverse function work? You will be given some y. Y between minus 1 and 1. So, minus 1 se 1 ke beech mein koi ek y given hoga. And you will be able to calculate using the sine inverse function some angle between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So, pi by 2 se minus pi by 2 ke beech ka koi ek angle aa jayega jab hume y given hoga. Also, the composition of the function, this also will work. That means, if I have sine of sine inverse y, I can say this is equals to y. The composition of function will work. You want to take theta in place of y, no problem, absolutely okay. You want to take x, that will also work. Other way, if I have sine inverse sine of x this time, if I want to take, this will be x. Of course, this time, see, yahan pe y is inside inverse function. This tells me that y will be in between 1 and minus 1. Why? Because sine inverse only know that I can work on some value which is a number from 1 to minus 1. And here, x is inside the sine function. X is being covered by sine function. That means sine only know how to operate on angles. That means x will be definitely from minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Some other properties. Small, they are very simple properties. Sine inverse y equals to 0 whenever y equals to 0. Of course, because for the principal branch, there is only one place where sine function will be 0, and that is 0 itself. Now, rest. There, I guess, most of the things are covered. If you want to break the function, let's break the function between positive and negative part. So, if sine inverse y is between pi by 2, I'll have to write the smaller quantity first, is between 0 to pi by 2. Then my y will be from 0 to 1. Positive values are being covered. And this 0 won't be covered because 0 is not taken here. And if I'm going from negative pi by 2 to 0, the negative part, that is covered from, if sine inverse y is from negative pi by 2 to 0, this will cover the negative part. The negative part. This. Okay. So this is just a breakup. Everybody knows that yes, negative part is being covered by 0 to negative pi by 2. Okay. You can switch the inverse function. Like suppose if you have sine x equals to y, then x will definitely be equals to sine inverse of y. You can switch the function like this. Or if you are given sine inverse y equals to x, you can take it back and it will become a sine function. Okay. Now I'll again write the principal branches. Anybody wants to take the screenshot of these properties can take. Then I'll write the, I'll make a table that will be principal branches as well as this. And then we'll plot some graphs. Possible. Nobody is interested. Okay, so again, you have to learn these values. First is sine inverse, the domain and the range. So domain for sine inverse is taken as negative 1, 1, and this will be taken from minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. For cos inverse function, this will again be from minus 1 to 1, and this time this will be from 0 to pi, the range. Then I have tan inverse function. Tan inverse take the value on whole of the real line R because it's unbounded function, and the range will be from negative pi by 2 to pi by 2. Why? Because R, the real line, this is also a kind of open interval. Clear? Ye bhi unbounded hota hai. Real line doesn't stop anywhere. So the corresponding range will be unbounded and it won't stop at pi by 2. That's why we have put it open brackets. Then I have cot inverse function. Cot inverse function, that is from R and 0 to pi again. Then cosec inverse. Cosec inverse is like minus infinity to minus 1. Why? Because this is reciprocal of sine. So reciprocal of sine means only this part won't be covered. Open interval. You can say, you can write it in other way also. I'll mention it. You can write it like R minus. Only this part, the part between negative 1 to 1 won't be covered. Rest, all the things will be covered. Its range will be from minus pi by 2 to 0 union 0 to pi by 2. And next and the last is secant function. So here I have the secant function, secant inverse, negative infinity minus 1 union 1 to infinity. You can also write, this is also again the same thing, and this goes from 0 to minus pi by 2 union pi by 2 to pi. Chaliye. Now we will shade a kind of region for their values. This covers region from here to here. This covers region from 0 to pi. This covers, this will be covering region from, I will make a small hole here, a round thing here, because it doesn't cover pi by 2 and minus pi by 2. So I have make a small hole. And this covers cot covers open bracket 0 to pi. So 0 and pi are not covered, rest of the things are covered. And this thing here, this covers minus pi by 2 to 0. So minus pi by 2 is being covered, whereas 0 is not being covered. Pi by 2 is being covered and this is not covered. 0 is not covered. So this is how this will work. And in the last, this one, this will be 0 is covered, but negative pi by 2 is not covered. I'll make a small hole. 0 is covered again, but no, this is from pi by 2 to pi. This hole on pi by 2 to pi, like this. So these are the principal branches. It's better if you are able to recall these graphs for sine, cos, tan, and this is cot, cosec, and secant. This will help you recalling the things. What values are being covered and what values are being left. Okay, so this is all what you have to do, what you have to understand properly. Okay, now we'll shade the graphs for the sine and the inverse functions. Possible will. Okay, possible we'll make it by this graph function if possible. Okay, first everybody is clear with the graph of sine function. This is the graph of sine function. It starts from 0, goes till 1, then like this. It starts going down, goes to minus 1, and then come back to 0. And so this value is negative 1, of course, and this value is 1, the highermost value. 1 is being covered at pi by 2. This is pi, 0 again, and this is negative pi, and this will be minus pi by 2. This is the graph for sine function. So for inverse function, how things will change?
Pi by 2.
This is pi by 2. Okay. So sine theta is between 1 and minus 1, where theta was between, theta could be anything here. Most probably it was from 0 to pi, you can say, or 2 pi, you can say, but theta is not necessary. Now, yahan pe, this was the minus 1 to 1 was the range. So for inverse function, 1 and minus 1 will serve as the domain. Domain, that means x kahan se kahan tak hoga. The x which I am going to put inside the inverse function. The x which I am going to put inside inverse function, this will vary from minus 1 to 1. So x, jo hum domain hota hai, domain is usually taken on x-axis. So this is the domain. So x will only vary from minus 1 to 1, and the function will take a look like this. It will go like this, and here it will start falling and then going down like this. So it will be like this. This is the graph for sine inverse y, where y equals to sine inverse x, you can take. This is the graph for sine inverse function, and this will be at pi by 2. The maximum value will be taken at pi by 2. So this is the domain. Dekhi, 1 hum put karenge. 1 is like this. So sine is 1. Where is sine is 1? At pi by 2. Elsewhere, at this. And minus 1. Hold on. This is supposed to be going through 0. Function is supposed to go from 0, that's why. This will be pi by 2 and this will be like this. Yeah. Okay, this is negative 1, this is 1. So function is having value 1 at pi by 2, this must be pi by 2. And function is having value minus 1 at negative of pi by 2, this is 0 at 0. I cannot do anything with that. Network problem hoga, tum logo ka hoga shayad. Chaliye, I'll try to speak a little bit slowly. So this is the function for sine inverse. In the same way, if you want to take the screenshot, then I'll make the function for cos inverse. And I don't know how to use this wind plot. You got it or not? Two-dimensional map, and there should be some equation. Explicit x sine x Okay, so if I am having the function as sine x here, okay, so this is the function for sine. If you can see, everybody can see, I guess. I'll increase this. So this was the curve for sine inverse function, and then I'll again plot. Inconsistent data. I don't know how to put this power. Inverse function. I don't know how to give command for the inverse function in this.
ये R पे लिख के कर लो.
हाँ?
ये R से लिख के.
हाँ यार C अक्ष है. X equals. Okay, but this is only taking value from this to this. So the second one here. Lower x, we have to make periodic. Oh, this is actually periodic function. So periodic, it will repeat arc sine x. I don't want this to be periodic anymore. I want it to be periodic. Actually, it will have to show, it should be showing, see, it's a, only showing the values from principal branch, I think. That's why. It's not showing the entire function. Okay. Okay, so I guess there's some idea. You can find out if they are giving the facility for inverse function. Okay, if I zoom down like this, then you can see that this is the sine and this will be the function for sine inverse. And it will keep on going like this. It will animate itself. Okay, so directly we can make the value for cos as well. So we can just change them and find the values for cos. It will be much easier. Cos function, then we then 5. Okay, so this will be the graph for the cos function. I guess everybody can see it starts from at 0, cos inverse is 1, and next we can just change this arc sine also to cos. I should leave them as empty. And then I can see this. Okay. Nothing to do. Okay, so cos function will be having like this. cos will be, this is 1, this is minus 1. So if I can make, yeah, I can show the lines as well for x equals to 1. X equals to 1. Okay. This will be 5. I'll make the line x equals to 1 also. The line x equals to 1, it cannot plot how. Cannot understand how the hell he cannot plot x equals to 1. So it should be a line, so I must make it a line segment. Oh my god. A equals to 1, the value for B will be 0, and the value for C will be 1, and then I can have it as 5. I can choose the color. This will be the line, x equals to 1. So this will actually now lie between this. And if I want to plot the line for this, y equals to 1, suppose. So a will be 0, the value for b will be 1, and the value for c will be again, I want to plot x equals to minus 1, I should plot. Yeah, x equals to minus 1, I should plot. So you can see everything will lie between this. Green again. Okay, so this is the line x equals to negative 1. So cos inverse function will range from minus 1 to 1. Whereas if I plot the line for this, if I want to plot the line, more lines, suppose for y equals to 1, I plot the line, then you can see that this will be in between. How sine and cos function actually changes. So this is 5. Okay. So if you see, this is the line for y equals to 1. And this limits my cos function. Whereas x equals to minus 1 and x equals to 1 limits my inverse function. So inverse function is tarike se. Yahan se aise jayega. And it will start to go up and up, up. Clear? So you can see the function have actually a kind of stand-up thing here. Okay, this was the thing for cos inverse function. And now if you see, if you take a look, that this is what? 0. And then it goes from here to here. So actually, y-axis will be at the time, it will serve as the angles. यहाँ पे देखो, यहाँ पे y axis is again in 1, 2, 3 in terms of radians. Clear? So instead you can take y axis in terms of angles as well. Pi by 2, pi, and then you can plot your graph. That will be a little bit better. It will give you a better look. And now if you want to plot tan and tan inverse function, again, I'll change a little bit. So this is tan function. Okay, so this is tan function in blue. It repeats itself. I'll have to. This is tan function repeating itself. And I'll delete these lines, x equals to 1. These lines also. And now we'll plot tan inverse function in red, arc 10. This is the tan inverse function. Clear? So tan inverse function goes. The tan inverse function goes from 0 to infinity like this. On the positive side, and here it goes on the negative side as well. Whereas tan function on x-axis, it will go from this to this. So if you can take a look, the graph have actually changed itself in the same way. Tan inverse and tan, each and every graph is related. Tan ka graph is tarike se hota hai. So tan inverse ka graph is tarike se hota. So So you can see that there is a change in the graph. Graph वैसा ही रहता है, but वो shift हो जाता है, वो change हो जाता है. Either it will change its axis. यहाँ पे क्या हुआ है? If these are the axes, जो y axis पे कर रहा था, now he is doing it on x axis. ऐसे ही हमने sine के साथ देखा. Sine was like this, and later on sine inverse was like this. So we are just actually changing the axis only. So you can see, if you rotate this graph, you'll be getting something like this. And if you rotate this graph, you'll be getting something like this. So they are quite related, the function and their inverse graphs. Okay, so this was tan function and the inverse. This is two dimension only or three dimensions? Okay. So cot inverse, secant inverse and cosecant inverse, you can do those graphs yourself, their regions. I guess everybody will be able to do. We'll finish it here. So what you are left with, cot inverse graph you have to make, secant inverse graph you have to make, cosecant inverse graph you have to make, and start learning the identities. I'll be giving you identities. This time we will be proving the identities. Some of the identities we will be proving. Clear? So that you can have a better idea of how to attempt a two proof type question. Okay, wherever there will be a question of proving something, so you will be getting some idea ki haan kis tarike se cheeze change hoti hain. So we'll be focusing more this time on proving the things and then doing the questions. Exercise will be given to you and then you can solve the exercise and the questions. Okay, this is enough for today. We'll start tomorrow again now.